Hi, this is Dr. Centeno, and I'd like to talk to you today about why we need to move away from the pain generator approach and treat the whole spine. Now, in interventional pain management, and those are doctors that do injections throughout the spine, we were taught to find one thing that's causing most of the pain and then inject that structure. This is called the pain generator approach. And the structure might be the facet joint, the spinal nerve, the disc, the SI joint, etc. But you focus on one thing. Now, interventional pain management physicians who were adding PRP and stem cells to their practices have really just begun to add those orthobiologics to the same pain generator concept. But is this the best way to apply orthobiologics to the spine, or are they missing a key thing here? Well, regrettably, like many things in medicine, the pain generator approach is really reductionist thinking, or trying to solve a problem by identifying its parts rather than treating the whole organ. The spine isn't just a collection of its pieces, it's a functional spinal unit, where all of those parts work together to withstand loads and protect the body. So with the advent of orthobiologics like PRP and stem cells that can actually heal or help heal tissues, I'm going to show you some data that may suggest that we need to throw out the pain generator approach and instead focus on trying to repair the function of the spine. So this is registry data on platelet-based whole functional spinal unit treatment, where high-dose PRP was injected into the facet joints, platelet lysate was injected with dextrose into the ligaments, and platelet lysate was injected with nanogram dexamethasone and ropivacaine epidural. And this data-driven registry product was really pulled together by the brilliance of Chris Williams, MD. He's a former Centeno-Schultz Clinic Fellow, now in Atlanta. And I am not easily impressed by many people, but I am very impressed by Chris. So, fluoroscopy-guided lumbar facet injections only. Now, this is registry data that Chris pulled. And what's interesting here is that you don't get to statistical significance in many of these time points. This is 1 month, 3 months, 6 months, 12 months, 18 months, and 24 months after the facet injection with PRP. So you see those two time points for the pain score are statistically significant, and this one over here for the functional score is statistically significant. So not that great. Now we add in here facet and ligament injections, two components of the functional spinal unit, and we see something completely different. Now all time points in both metrics are statistically significant. And we see the same thing if we add in the facet plus the ligament plus the epidural. And this really goes in contrast to what the pain generator approach says you should do. It's actually doing the opposite, which seems to work much better here. So while this is registry data, it seems to show that injecting the whole functional spinal unit produces better results with orthobiologics than just injecting a single structure. And you have to ask the question, is it time to get rid of the pain generator approach? So thanks so much for watching and have a great day.